Hello guys, welcome back to this video. So guys, in today's video I'm going to show you how to go to back to the stock room from your MIUI. So as you can see, this is the latest build of the Xiaomi.eu, and then after no one is porting the room. So I am thinking to make a video on this topic, how to go to stock from MIUI. So you need to follow some steps which are very important. Some people flash directly fast boot room, so they brick their device. So I will show you a proper method how to go from fast boot mode to there. So first of all, you need to back up your data and PC, and you need to download your fast boot ROM, and you need a ADB driver installed PC. So guys, there may noise in background, so sorry for that. So you need to boot your device into recovery mode. So it is booting now. I will take you directly to the recovery screen. So guys, as you can see, my device has been successfully booted into TWR mode. So now you need to click on this wipe button. Click on this advanced Dalvik system data and click on this swipe to wipe, and you need to format your internal also. Some important files are there in my mobile, so I will take them into my PC backup, then I will wipe it. So you need to click on this mount system, then you need to wipe and go to system, wipe it. So as you can see, let me show you whether my system shows or not. So as you can see, it shows system 4 MB. So now you need to boot your device into fast boot mode and connect to PC. So I will show you directly to the PC. So guys, as you can see, I have connected my device through PC by the help of USB cable. As you can see, I have connected it. So I will show you all process in the PC only by screen recording. So your device should be charged above 60% so that you can complete flashing process easily. If your device breaks, then also you can recover it easily if your device is charged about 60%. So I will show you all process in the PC. So guys, as you can see, I have extracted here, downloaded this fast boot ROM and extracting in my PC. So you need to extract in a folder where you can locate it easily. So you need to extract that fast boot ROM, and you need to open Mi Flash Tool. So you can use Mi Flash Tool or Mi Flash Tool Pro, and now I am using Mi Flash Tool Pro. So after opening Mi Flash Tool Pro, it will take some time, and you need to click on this warning yes, then it will be opened. So no need to worry. So I will take you directly here after completing opening of the Flash Tool. Yes, before flashing your device, you need to type fast boot erase. So let me type here fast boot erase user data. So this will wipe user data which you have flashed when flashing the MIUI ROM. So if you haven't flashed user data, then no problem. If you have flashed, then you need to type this command. So after typing this, then it will show like erasing user data. So it will show, if it will show like finished, then just close this window and open Mi Flash Tool or Mi Flash Tool Pro, whatever it may be, and it will show your device name like this. So you need to type, click here, flash in fast boot. If you are using normal Mi Flash Tool, then it will open directly. So let me show open directly. So let me open Mi Flash Tool. So guys, as you can see, now I am opening the Mi Flash Tool, and it says locate the folder where you kept the fast boot ROM. So I am locating the folder. So I have kept in PC, C drive, ADB. So you need to locate where you kept it. So let me locate it inside this PC, ADB, sorry. So here is ADB file, and inside the fast boot ROM, I have kept it over here. So you need to select the file above one images. So just click on this OK button and click on this refresh button. So if you click on that refresh button, your device will show. It will show your device ID, like serial number. As you can see, it is showing my device serial number. Here is, as you can see, and just click on this refresh button again and click on this flash button. So it will start flashing your device. Don't disconnect your device while flashing it, otherwise you may brick your device hardly, and you may need to change your motherboard.
So guys, I will take you directly here. After completing a flashing, it may take 700 to 800 seconds. One more thing I forgot to say to you people is you need to select this flash all and lock, so it will clean all your data and it will lock your bootloader. You can unlock it. So if you don't select this clean all and lock, your device will not boot and it will lead to boot loop. So let us wait until flashing completes. So I will take you directly here after completing of flashing. Don't worry if it shows like MI flash tool is not responding or any other thing. After completing of flashing, your device will reboot automatically. You need not to do anything. So guys, as you can see, the flashing is now going on and it says set active. Don't do anything until it shows result success. So it may show like set active A, set active B. So don't worry, wait until it shows success result and your device may reboot while completing this process. Nothing will be happen to your device. So as you can see, my device is now rebooting and my PC recognized it. That's why it is making nice notification sound. So let us wait until it shows success.
Yes, as you can see, the flashing is going on but my device is rebooted. As you can see, if your device reboots, just disconnect your device through PC and just complete your setup. So as you can see, I am disconnected my device and still the process is going on. That may be flash tool problem. So don't worry, don't go with that. As you can see, my networks are came, there is no any issue or nothing. So just complete your setup. I will take you directly to the home screen. So guys, as you can see, finally my device is rebooted and there is no any network issue. As you can see, my both Jio SIM cards are working, which are dual 4G SIM cards. And let me show you whether my Android version is what. So I have flashed the January firmware. Let me show you my Android version. So here, as you can see, let me click on this Android version. So as you can see, my Android version. So that's it for today's video guys. Share with your friends so that they will be able to know, and subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos and updates. So just I have installed the this ROM, completed setup, haven't did any email ID or any other thing. So I will add it later. That's why it is sending notifications like that. So bye bye guys.